Hallelujah! Welcome to Evangelist Gibson Chidebere Eze online YouTube channel. I'm so happy today coming your way. It is wonderful to be in God's presence today. I believe you have always been blessed listening to us. If today, by God's grace, is your first time of tuning in, I want to humbly say to you, welcome to the environment of great impartation, environment where hope comes alive, environment where God imparts our life, giving us reason to live again. Welcome. By God's grace, if today is your first time of tuning in, again, I would like to tell you, it is good for me to encourage you to subscribe to this channel. The reason why you have to subscribe is so that you can be able to get many more of our messages as we upload them. I believe that God will bless you and God will continue to increase your life even as you acquire more knowledge and apply the Word of God into your life. God bless you as you do that in Jesus' name. By God's grace, I would like to share with you a very important topic today. 5 major roadblocks to divine healing. 5 major roadblocks to divine healing. This message is going to be a continuation of our last discussion, if you have been following. And if you have not been following and today is your first time, you subscribe quickly and go to our channel so that you can be able to be following as we keep uploading all the series. We want to continue by saying today's topic again, 5 major roadblocks to divine healing. We said a lot about divine healing last time. We talked about facts that you need to know for divine healing to manifest in your life. We said a lot about you understanding the will of God. We said a lot about you doing knowing that God is a healer. We said a lot about divine healing. And by the grace of God, we also were able to talk about 5 things you have to do to access divine healing. We talk about the place of the anointing. We talk about the place of laying of hands. We talk about the place of faith. We talk about the power or the force of agreement. We talk about the force of agreement. We talk about a lot. So if today is your first time, try to go back, subscribe and get there quickly so that you can follow up the series as I continue from where I stopped last time. By God's grace, today we want to look at the roadblocks, things that block people from receiving healing. I've seen many people come out for healing in crusades, conferences. As a gifted preacher in the area of healing, I've seen many people try to access the healing power of God. I've seen others healed. And I've seen many others struggle, go back home the same way, crying and weeping. Many of them believe God have failed them. But I want to sound this clear. God is never a failure. God is still the healing God. God still heal and God deliver. Having said that to you, let me tell you one major roadblock. One major roadblock. The number one that hinders many people from accessing God's healing. Number one is wrong mindset. Wrong conception. Wrong belief in the mind of people. Hebrews 11 verse 6, God says, let whoever will come to me must first of all believe that God is the rewarder of everyone that comes to him. You must first of all believe that without faith, it's impossible to please God. It's impossible to please God without faith. And you must also know that God is a rewarder of them that comes to him. Whoever seeks God must know that. So you need faith in place. But the problem here about faith is that many people have wrong belief, wrong mindset. For example, I once met a woman who shared with me a lot. And she said to me she's sick for up to 15 years now. She needs instant healing. Say, Brother Gibson, I believe God that if you can join me in prayer, that I will be healed. I was willing to do that, beloved. But I decided to ask her one or two questions. Do you believe that God can heal you? She said, yes, I believe. I believe. I know that my problem is spiritual. And I said, how do you know? Have you gone to hospital? Look at the symptoms. She started telling me all the symptoms. But she has never visited hospital for 15 years. She has never gone to hospital to find out what exactly is the problem. Whether the problem is the one that she doesn't even need any kind of prayer, long prayer, just a very simple prayer with one or two medication from the hospital, she will be healed. But she has a wrong mindset that her problem is not the type she has to go to hospital. So she sit down. She sit down at home, daily crying and weeping, passing through the pain, believing that one day, God will come and deliver. We have many Christians who have a wrong mindset. They believe that going to hospital means you don't have faith. It's not true. When you go to hospital, it helps you to identify the problem. When you go to hospital, sometimes also help you to know the name of the problem. And even as they are treating you in the hospital, you must know that it is Jesus that healed. Even the doctor can't doubt the fact that God is a healer. So sometimes God can use prayers and doctor's medication mixed together to heal you. And when doctor's medication fail, you know the name of the sickness. And then you can invoke the name that is above all other names, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And his name heal the sick. But many people don't even bother to go to hospital at all. They apply faith without even knowing what they are suffering from. So that is number one problem. Some other people, I've seen people, I counsel some other people who are like Naaman in 2 Kings chapter 5. Naaman coming to prayer from the prophet of God, Elisha. And Naaman believed that if I come to him, he's going to pray. He was coming to God with all the ego, personality involved. So he, as he was coming with all the entourage, he was shocked by God. God who do not walk in the ways of men. God whose way are different from the ways of men. Naaman came believing this is the way God has to do it. They will invoke God and pray for me. But God shocked him. Elisha sent Gehazi go and tell Naaman to dip herself, himself, I mean, just 7 times in River Jordan, and he will be fine. Surprisingly, Naaman felt, no, how can you say that? I have better rivers. I have better swimming pools in my place. How can I dip myself in Jordan River? But that is where God intervened. That is where God wants the healing to come from. Many people have wrong conception. They just believe this is the way it has to be. Even when God is saying, I will heal you, he believes it's that after my fibroid operation. When God said, I'm going to bless you, he said, I know that is after my brother in London sent me money. God is not talking about your brother in London. God can use anybody, anywhere in Nigeria abroad to change anybody's life. Wrong belief, wrong mindset. Wrong mindset. Many people have this wrong mindset. They say, if God will heal me, he will heal me. If God will change my life, he will change my life. They just believe. Say they believe. On what ground is your belief? You see, healing comes by revelation. If you don't know the revelation of God's word, what are you placing your faith on? You have to place your faith on something. You have to believe on something. So on what ground are you believing? Do you have revelation of the word? Many people don't have any revelation of the word. Many people don't spend time to find out what God has to say about sickness and disease. On what ground are you exercising your faith? If you don't have revelation, when God says, I am the Lord, I healed thee. How strong is that to you? If you don't see it and meditate on it until it sinks into your spirit, it sinks into your mind, and then that word have to sink in the realm of meditation, the word give birth to faith in you. Faith come alive and jump out of you, and it voice out through your words. But many people don't have the anchor verse. What are you anchoring your faith upon? Some people's faith is just anchored on certainties. They anchored it on certainties. They say, if God wants to heal me, he will heal me. You are anchoring it on events. You are anchoring it on people. No, your faith must be on the word of God. You must have your word. You must have your belief. If you believe that by his stripes you are healed, where did he say it? On what are you believing? Are you strong about it? Your word, your message must have the right mindset. You must have the right mindset to be able to get the healing. Because if you don't have the right mindset, it will not burst out from your mouth. Faith have to be built up in you. So wrong mindset have been the major problem of people. If you want to receive healing, change your mindset and you will change your destiny. Number two is what I call doubt. Many people doubt God. Many people doubt is not unbelief. Don't mistake it. Doubt is not unbelief. Unbelief simply means you don't believe at all. But doubt is that you believe. You believe. But the circumstance around is giving you reason to consider what you believe again. The circumstance around what you see is not confirming what you believe. What you see is not rhyming with what you believe. But the truth is this, that faith is not based on fact. Faith is based on truth. John 8:32 says, you shall know the truth, and the truth set you free. What is the truth? The truth is in verse 36. If the Son of God set you free, you are free indeed. So when you are operating in faith, don't walk by sight. Many a times your body may not be saying what you believe. You believe that you will have your baby. And then you look at the medical report, it's saying something different. So faith is not based on reports. That is why the Bible says, who will believe our report? To whom have the arm of flesh been revealed to? Who have God revealed his power to? Faith is not based on what we see. Faith is an evidence of things not seen. So many people say they are believing in God, but it's a lie. They are believing in what they see. What they see control them. When you have faith, you act on what God's word say. You are not controlled by what you see. So anytime you want to have faith, remove doubt. James chapter 1 verse 6 to 8 talks about you not wavering in your heart. You have to come to God acting in faith, not wavering in your heart, not having double mind. Your mindset must be made up that God indeed is a healer, that God is a prayer answering God. Don't base your faith on what you see, because what you see will fail you. Don't base your faith on feeling. Your feeling may fail you sometimes. Several times many people's feeling fails. Faith is not based on what we see. Faith is not based on feeling either. Faith is based on the word of God. If you base it on feeling, feeling dwindles. Feeling changes. Feeling changes. Weather, situation changes. But when you believe in faith, only the word of God stands forever. The word of God remains. Number three is what I call lack of expression of faith. Many people don't see healing because they find it difficult to express their faith. Look, the Bible says something. That faith is an evidence of something you hope for. So when you say you have faith, you have to believe and then act what you hope to see. It's an evidence that what you hope for, you will get it. When you say you have faith for God to give you children, where is your baby material? Go right into the market, buy baby materials. If you say you have faith for healing, why are you still there? Sitting down on the bed of sickness. Get up and get out of the house. Mark chapter 5. The woman of the issue of blood had faith. And she said to herself, if I touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. Fine. But she didn't sit down there. She got up and expressed her faith. You have to express your faith. Bartimaeus believed in Mark 10:47. He heard the word and he expressed his faith. He cried out, Son of David, have mercy on me. In John chapter 5, the man have faith. So when you say you have faith, you can't have faith and sit down there. You can't have faith and keep murmuring. You can't have faith and keep complaining that God doesn't want to help you. You can't have faith and say nothing is working. You have to get up. Show your faith. If you have faith that God will give you a job, if you have faith that God will heal you, you have to express your faith. And unexpressed faith is not faith at all. When you have faith, you have to express it. Faith is seen by expression. Number four. I need you to know that faith doesn't base on physical things we see. So therefore, faith is expressed in confession. Number four, wrong confession. Many people don't see healing because they have wrong confession. When you see many people who are believing God for healing, they keep confessing negative things. They keep telling you, I'm not seeing any result. Look at me, I'm still feeling the pain. Nothing is working in my life. Nothing is working. You see them murmuring. Listen to me. Faith has a language. When you see someone that has faith, you will see it in the way he talks.